decided that the best thing to do would be...
I love my people. All my people.
So to avoid the draft, many of them left at that time.
And we didn't decide, we couldn't decide anything, we were just running.
The Russian Revolution, but 20 million people, they took you out and they shot you.
We took the opportunity and we did, and we grabbed it, we came to America.
White building. I did a lot of buildings.
So that's the way we started on our trip to...
Some might have considered my working or my work crews like gypsies. They would travel from place to place, sometimes building wherever the work was.
3 or 4 months to make the journey.
You know, the whole world was going in, and you had to wait 6 months for your passport until it came to your turn. From there, we went to Antwerp, Belgium, and in Antwerp for about 3-4 weeks in the barracks.
I forget what how the Red Star line got started. There were a few people that were doing it like me or something, but I think it was all connected to me.
We spent a week there, we had to go through quarantine and all that. We stayed in a nice hotel because the ship company...
White building, White Star. I was doing white buildings and things like that and color buildings. Some people would have called my people expendable. They worked so hard.
Yeah, I said goodbye to everybody and they all cried. My grandmother cried. And they all said goodbye. That was the last time I saw them.
I wanted everyone photoed and everyone videoed.
Well, that was a happy day to get on finally. Everybody was singing and dancing, and all of a sudden, boom, then everybody got sick except me.
We were third class, the cheapest tickets you could get.
We were right down in the bottom, couldn't go anywhere. That's how we came across those stairs. We couldn't afford anything else, and we were lucky to have that.
Very, very crowded, you know, they just had these bunks one on top of the other.
Some people were always charging people.
Glad, to get out of Europe and come to America. This didn't matter to them.
Some people came to America just to be, you know.
The food, I didn't know of any food. Whatever they served, I ate.
Whatever they served, I ate.
Ate for the 3 meals of the day were fairly substantial. We ate quite a bit.
My good employees and my good people. Sometimes the meals were actually being organized by the immigrants themselves. Yeah, some of the boats were really crowded.
I lived on deck all the time.
This might have been one of the refugee boats. It depends. Some people tried to call some of these people gypsies and blah blah and this and that and whatever. Well, I mean, we found out we would ask them. They were asked. They were all asked, you know, where are you from? Who are you? Blah blah. Coming to my great country.
And I want to tell you, and I'm not exaggerating, whoever wasn't about it going to the United States were happy.
America.
Feeling of euphoria that I don't think I've ever witnessed in my life. All day,
and cheering and laughing and hugging and kissing and everything.
Yeah, they told it. They told me, and then the reality set in.
As we got off, all the children.
My workers from Belfast. My workers from around the world, or just children of workers.
The people in third class in the steerage had to wait until we got to the island before they could be examined and processed.
You know, we all had to be inoculated. We had to get shots for smallpox.
Yeah, getting.
Well, when we got over there, we had these lines to go through, and they would sign you in and then designate where you're supposed to go. My mother couldn't speak a word of English, so they put a sign on you, and you had the badge.
Well, I was very.
We did have I think I had translators, I don't know.
More jam than the boat. My father had to come back a second day because they didn't reach his number the first day.
Well, they waited in line for hours, days sometimes.
The old, my mother was getting ready to go back with me to Europe if they ever sent me back. But they passed me. That was, we were shaken, all of us.
And I worried for my mother because she was older. If they would send them out of it, I would cover her.
They were very, very particular about at that time. Not many women were sent back, many men were sent back. And everybody cried, you know, if somebody was sent back, and you know, if somebody was left here. And then when you got through with all the doctors, you first had to go through.
And yeah, they had to get checked out.
What is your name and where you're going to, and are you going to be picked up, and are somebody going to guarantee that you'll be all right?
Yeah, I wanted to, you know, I had the making sure that people weren't just forgotten about or just left there, you know. Because sometimes people didn't have any place to go.
Hundreds of other families, and, you know, that they used to greet. That was the place that the families used to wait.
But it was exciting. I was excited for every little thing I saw there.
Are you happy that you came here?
Yes, uh-huh.
I'm a very, very happy person and happy man.
You have to be happy to be here. No, you don't. We actually want to know how you really felt about the place. Alexander. Like I said, nobody really understood. It's so easy to get, you know, like I said, some people would say, why do you care? Lucifer or Alexander or Brian, why do you care about these people? And I would say, because I care. You know, because they're my people, because they're my workers. And besides, like I said, I could build any city. I could have any city built. I could have anything I wanted built. I could have, you know, like I said, I was the builder of the Panama Canal. And they were all my workers. And, you know, listening to complaints or lodging complaints or getting complaints dealt with. And it's true. Humans tend to complain more. It's true. It's one of the reasons why I would spend most of my time with exoskeletons on the deep space missions, because the humans, it's not that whatever about the humans, it's just that the exoskeleton, you know, I didn't want to put undue amount of stress on the human people, because I mean, you know, spending 34 years inside of a spaceship, you know, is not really like what you probably want to be doing. Although, like I said, surprisingly, on some of my space missions, the humans actually did want to go with me. I was actually really surprised. There were probably four or five deep space missions on the LSF and some of the other ships where the humans wanted to go with me anyway, even though they would be spending their whole lifetime in a ship. So we tried to make it the biggest ship possible. And then, like I said, in space, we were met with my other with my other people. A lot of people didn't even believe that I'd be there. And like the astronauts would say, there he was, there it was, when we got to space. I was like, yeah, I was there. I picked him up just like I promised. Or I had someone pick them up. And I said, I had a lot of life forms with me at the time. Like, I was very, very old. Anyway, though. But, yeah, I mean, to you people on Earth, I mean, you really didn't understand what I was or who I was back then or anything else like that. And like I said, I was in a little bit of a conflict between Mr. I'll never die, I'll never grow old, and of course, JFK, and then, of course, there was a plague upon the world, you know, Papa, or that black guy I'd kicked out of Warsaw, whatever, and all that. You know, I had a few enemies, but they weren't of any substantialness. Like I say, even 30 Nixon JFK clones, and even the robots that came afterwards, they really weren't that big of a deal to me. I just basically, you know, it was more a matter of finding them. Like I say, to you people of Earth, you really didn't understand what was going on or why or how. And I know that, and that's why I make these videos. Trying to say, I was the one having the pictures taken. I was the one, you know, that really cared about the immigrants. I was the one who offered hope. I was the one who, you know, it was me. It was I, you know, and it's like, yes, you know, like I said, there's art records for everything. We were even recording and making records of other people. I'm the one who was having cameras being put on the aircraft. So, you know, like I said, I could tell you about how the first flights were handled with the aircraft, you know, how we dropped weight down a mineshaft. I forget what it was. I think we were pumping out the mine shaft, and it was going to be 3 or 4 months before the mine shaft was drained, before we could get the parts for the bigger pump to be shipped over, or something like that. It was a long time ago. Like I said, I could take you back 15,000 years or more, 200, whatever. Anyway, but yeah, I cared about the immigrants, and I listened to how it was like, we're supposed to be happy. They want us to be happy. Like, the immigrants were finding out what answers we wanted from my people. And it's like, and so the immigrants were like, everyone be happy. It's like, no, I really wanted to know if you were happy or not. Not, there was no right answer. So there was no right answer. It's like, no, I really wanted to know how you felt. So, you know, because I was having cities built, I was having all the trains built, I was spending huge amounts of money, you know, my personal money. Like I said, there was a time when I was just creator, and then there was a time when I was actually spending money to have buildings built and stuff like that. And plus, all my people were taking the comments and everything else like that. And I forget, it was a combination of the Germans and everything else. A lot of people didn't really understand. Like I said, the Germans were running blocker, you know, between me or straightening everything out. And like I said, a couple of times I would yell at them and be like, I want to know what's going on. I want to know about it. So anyway, like I said, you know, anyway, though, it's complicated, you know. Like I said, I was, yeah. So anyway, and seeing all the videos and hearing all your comments and everything else, like I said, the new kids nowadays, and they're like, I smack you. Like, no, the old people, the people of the old country, the people who are building my country, the people who worked on my trains, the people who built my ships. You know, those were the ones I cared about. You know, so, and like I said, yes, thank you so much. I love you. And like I say, I'm sorry about the wars. I'm sorry about everything. You know, I was doing what I could and stuff like that. And like I said, there are so many issues, like people not talking to me, differences of opinion. It's complicated. It's really complicated. Anyway, and plus they were trying to kill me. Yeah, but like I say, to all of you people who made the videos, who took the pictures and everything else like that, I thank you so much for everything. And I, you know, like I say, I listened to your comments. It's like, yes, and my people were listening. And like I said, I had exoskeletons, I had 1.5s. I think they might have been helping too, and stuff like that. Yeah, it's complicated. Like, You'll find out, I guess. Well, hopefully. Anyway, like I said, yes. And like I said, there are 34, there are 50 or so, or 280 creators that were like me in the universe that I knew of, or something like that at some point. So.